Hello and welcome to this rightmem.co.uk video tutorial on configuring Stackwise Virtual on the Cisco 9400 series in 7 easy steps. In this topology, to keep things simple, we're going to be using the same interfaces on both sides of the Stackwise Virtual. So Stackwise Virtual link made up of two links, 10.2/0/1 and 10.2/0/2, and the dual active detection link will be made up of 2/0/3 on each side. If you want to find out a bit more about what these things are, then please visit rightmem.co.uk/stackwise-virtual. Step 1 is to connect and verify your interfaces. So I've gone away and connected my interfaces according to the topology diagram, and now with show CDP neighbours, from each switch we'll check to see that the layer 2 connectivity is there. Step 2 is very simple. We'll go into configuration mode on each chassis and enter the command stackwise-virtual. Both switches in a stackwise virtual need to have the same domain ID. In this example, I'll set the domain ID to 100. Do remember that these commands have to be entered on both switches. Step 4 is to enable our stackwise virtual link. So with this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select both of my interfaces on chassis A. So that's 2/0/1 and 2/0/2. And I'm going to enable the stackwise virtual link with the command stackwise-virtual link 1. Remember, you have to do this for both chassis, so you'll need to enter the same commands on chassis B as well. Next up, we enable our heartbeat link called the dual active detection link on interface 10.2/0/3. This link prevents both chassis believing they are the active control plane, even if the SVL is lost. Now we key in the reload command and wait. When I was doing this, it took about 20 minutes for both chassis to come back up. As I'm sure you'll be glad to know, I've cut this bit out. You've got to love post-production. After the reboot, I've entered the show switch command, and I can now see that we've got an active switch and a standby switch. Now, if I was to hop over to chassis B and do the same, we can see that we don't get anything back. It's the console has been disabled. And that's because we're now using Stackwise Virtual to manage two switches as one. Great, now it's all set up, let's verify our configuration. So we can see with the show Stackwise Virtual command that the Stackwise Virtual is enabled, that the domain number is 100, and we can also see the interfaces on each switch that are part of the Stackwise Virtual link. You can see the bandwidth of the SVL by using the show Stackwise Virtual bandwidth command. From each switch's perspective, we can see that 20 gigs worth of bandwidth is available, which is correct as we have two 10 gig links. To verify our dual active detection link, we can use the show Stackwise Virtual dual active detection command. Now that just shows us that we have the two ports, one on each chassis, and they're both in the upstate. Stackwise Virtual link command just gives us a little bit more information than we've already seen on the SVL. It shows us the interfaces again, the switches that they're connected to, and it gives a bit more information on the layer 1 and layer 2 status. We can also take a bit of a look at another command that shows the neighborship, show Stackwise Virtual neighbors. Again, it just shows the local and the remote ports that we're connected to. In our case, it's very simple as we've connected each side to the same ports, but if you had to do yours differently for whatever reason, this would make it easier to see where your connections are. If you needed any further proof that the Stackwise Virtual was now up and we're managing two switches as one, if we do a show IP interface brief, we can see that the interface is on chassis A, so the 10.1 designations refer to the first chassis in the stack. And then for chassis B, we can see that the 10.2 are just scrolling down on the screen now. And we can manage those both from the same place. And finally, if we run a show CDP neighbors, we can see that the two chassis are no longer adjacent to each other because they now are each other. It's good to be aware of the fact that even though it doesn't show in show VLAN, VLAN 4094 is reserved for the Stackwise Virtual, so you can't use this for your own data. By default, Stackwise Virtual will elect a switch in the stack to be the active control plane. If we want to change this ourselves, we can do this with the priority command and also the renumber command. So by default, each of the chassis is assigned a priority of 1, We can change that to a higher number to make it more preferred. Here I change the priority of switch 2 to 15 to make it more preferred. This will only take effect after a reboot. If, like me, having the active switch as switch number 2 doesn't feel quite right, you can just renumber it with the switch 2 renumber 1 command. So that's renumbering switch 2 to switch 1. This will require a reboot. And there we go. We can rest easy, safe in the knowledge that they've been renumbered correctly. If you enjoyed this video, please check out the full article on rightmem.co.uk/stackwise-virtual, where you'll find lots of other of my content. And please also subscribe to my YouTube channel, Rightmem TV.